What's up, buddies? You know me, I'm BC. Welcome back to another episode of Sky Factory 3. Yeah. So, let's see how we're doing here. We got 28, 39, 19, and 3. So, we're still doing all right. I've had to upgrade these guys. Let me show you how to put an emerald upgrade into it. Just give us a little higher, because these were all 8 stacks and all full. In here, we got some extra stuff. We got Mysterious Dark Potion. Golden Apples, that's going to be nice. But yeah, we got a whole bunch of good stuff going on. What else have we updated? Well, we have moved all this around. So, we have our lava generators, or the crucibles are still up here. But the lava generators, I dropped down here and made a couple more. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I need one more lava generator that I can upgrade it to tier 2. So maybe this episode we can do that. I was looking at it already. We are going to need an Enderman soul vial. So I think if I just go to my mob farm and I remove the killer, it should be good. Should be good. Let's get down here. Down here is where my obsidian chest is. And we got 9 stacks, so that's good. We've got some serious obsidian happening. And right here is what we're going to start with today. I'll show you the Botania a little later. I'll show you what I got done. So, we are going to look into some actually additions. And let me just pop this up here. Actually... So I accidentally made this guy super easy to make, though. I was going to get it ready, but got a little ahead of myself and I made it. But this is the crafting block for actually additions. My inventory is unbelievably full. Let me just draw all this crap out of there. There, right now, this is what we need. So I'm also going to need a redstone torch. Oh, I got a little bit of... juddering happening. There we are, redstone torch. So, I don't know if you guys have seen actually additions before, but it is pretty darn sweet. If I can place it. Okay, perfect. That was just a little leg, maybe. Oh, and you can see it's shooting already, so that's a good sign. I'm going to turn it to pulse, which will be controlled by a redstone signal. And just make a button. Just for right now, we're probably going to automate it pretty soon, but... that is good. It's hooked right up to our main system here. So we have a lot of stored power. But how this works, this is, yeah, like I said, this is the main crafting block. So we need to... get a few things here. A couple of them. And a couple of them. I think that's what we need. And so now that I have that there, hit this button. It shoots into this block and stops. So if I drop, let's just go 6 of each. I don't want that gone, but hopefully that won't destroy anything extra. There we are. So this guy here basically converts normal items into the actually additions items. So I think as long as I have the power, because this does use quite a bit of power. Let's take a look how these guys are doing. They still seem to be all right. That's good. Doesn't seem to be hurting too much. So let's get into actually additions. First, we're going to start with this energy laser relay. Let's see here. So we need black quartz and 4 resonating crystals. So there we are. Start with this guy. Perfect. We probably want to make a couple. Whoops. There we are. Let's go with 5. And then I'll need my obsidian. Let's see here. Gold. Do I have some gold? Put the gold in here as well. Whoa. So next up, to get this guy ready, we're going to need this. Get them all in there. And then... I think we're up to there, so we need some obsidian. And some... What else was that? Redstone blocks. Wow. It is pretty heavy on the redstone. That's cool, though. Because of all my toys, we are doing pretty good on our redstone. So we can make two of these. Excellent. So I'm also going to need this laser wrench. We can make one there. There we are. And how this works. Okay, so I think... I mean, we got that far already. We should be able to get rid of these, actually. I might need a better power source, though. Just see, can I put the relay right there? And the relay right there. And if I right-click with the laser wrench, there we are. So now we should be getting power. Excellent. So this is basically wireless power. It does only go 15 blocks. But come on, 15 blocks, that'll do great for what we need. So let's see what else. I think we also want to make... where was it? The farm or something we're going to be doing, but not quite yet. Crusher. So the crusher is basically like the SAG mill. So to build a crusher, hit the right button. What are we missing? Basic coils. There. And I'm already out of redstone. Okay, we're going to go upstairs. I also made the elevator block just to move us around a little quicker. What do we have in here for redstone? Just a stack and a bit. But down here, I bet you we might have what we need. Maybe. Wow, that's not very good either. But it'll do. So we want to drop... Let's just go with 36 more. And if you look, because it doesn't have a GUI, you can't get into it. It shows you in the bottom left-hand corner here how much RF is in it. 300,000. What it's on. All that good stuff. So that's good. Lets you know what you're doing. So what else do we need? Cobblestone and flint. And more of these. So we need... Cobblestone, flint, more iron, a little bit of that. So we'll need at least two of these. Let's go with four. And I think I'm ready for two more of these. There we are. So I can make this crusher. We can make two of them. And then, why don't we upgrade it right away to a double crusher? There, now we have a double crusher. And how double crushers work, let me show you. This is super cool. I don't know where I'm going to put it yet, but I was just going to start building down here. Drop it over there. We want to bring the laser over to this one as well. And you can just laser it from anywhere as long as it's in the line. Let's go into it and look at that. Now we have double crusher, 60,000 RF. And we can, yeah, jump back and forth from RF to Tesla, super easy. Let's see, we have nothing we can, oh, I wonder what that does. And you can auto split items. So you hit that button. Now it's gonna evenly bring it between the two. Oh, sand, that makes sense. Then if you take half of this out, it's gonna automatically make it even. So that is super slick. Let's get rid of this. There. So that's gonna be really great. And it does double ores, so we might even not need our smelter anymore. Maybe. But we also can take this energy laser, throw it down, shoot it, and what do we have next? A fluid laser relay. Uh-huh. So I want one more fluid laser. Then from here, we can throw these fluid lasers down. And then they upgrade into item laser relays. So how these work, let me just make sure I know how. I think so. You basically put them anywhere. Let's just get that going. Hold a compass to modify. Maybe I might need a compass. Is there like a special compass for here? Probably not. Another thing we're going to need soon, wings of the bat. Not too hard to do as soon as I can get another star. And then we'll have creative flying, which will be very nice. Okay, so why did I just come up here? We're making a compass. I'm losing my mind as well. Compass is pretty easy. Compass, yeah. Oh, and I probably have that in my inventory right now, don't I? Compass. And a redstone. Can I? Oh, all right. Right click to east. Oh. Huh. Pretty sweet, but we have to hook this, I think, into, where did this guy go? At actually additions. An item interface. Can we make that right now? We might need a few more things. Let's see. I think I need some more basic coils. That was pretty dumb. Missing three more basic coils. There, now we have all four. A chest. Do I have wood right there? Oh, I even got chest, even better. Perfect. That's this. Get this guy out. And then with the item interface, we can move this hopefully upstairs. So I thought I knew how to do. Let's see here. Break this one. And I want to put it right here. Connect you again. And then we have to pipe items into here. Yeah, if you pipe items into this guy here, it'll go into this chest. But if you put a hopper underneath it, you should be able to pull everything out of this chest. I think I'm about to test that, guys. Why don't I take a quick break? I'm going to move it upstairs. We're going to test it and get it working. Be right back. Welcome back, buddies. I keep forgetting to mention, these skeleton horses kind of spawned. I don't know, I think I was AFK a couple days ago or like 5 days ago. And these guys just appeared. They didn't kill me, thankfully. They were just sitting around. And all was good. But we have a problem. I need, before I can set up these auto wireless item relay, laser relays, I'm going to build the, what am I, an extra, I need storage. I need a storage controller. That one, drawer controller. But I need nether quartz. And how to get nether quartz is if you put soul sand in a sieve. But to get soul sand, that's where it gets difficult. But this guy's actually super easy. Sand with witch water. The way to get witch water is to put a stone barrel, which I happen to have a few more of. There they are. And I'm just going to turn this whole thing into mycelium. Because it will most likely go a little quicker if you do it that way. Also an easy way to get mushrooms, obviously. But you get the mycelium by getting these ancient spores and just planting them. Brings out mycelium. Pretty awesome. Let me just fill up these buckets. Gonna have to find a better way to fill them up in a second here. But if you look, they're all transforming. This guy is fully transformed into witch water. So I believe all I have to do is right click sand into it, and we got there. That's awesome. So I'm going to need I think I will just need these guys here, and this guy will go into infinite water source. Can I just do it like that? I don't even know. That would be pretty sweet if I can just transfer node fluids. That's not right. Put dirt down. Transfer node. It doesn't look like it. Okay, let's see here. What other infinite water sources can we find? Be right back. Oh, well, that's a cool one. So in actually additions, there's actually where is it? Fluid collector. Really easy auto breaker, super easy to make. As long as we have void crystals, and we do. I found them in a rare chest. Now, there we are. Let's put you right here. I don't even know what to get rid of anymore there. So we need to drop down. I keep running to the corner there, but I blocked that off because we have this. So, to make the fluid collector, we need cobblestone, which I think I can get right from here. Yes. So we need that. No, we need four of these guys. Bless me. Get rid of that right now. We need four. We need one of these guys. Fluid collector. We're a block breaker first. Fluid collector. Oh. Get that. Come on. Now, we need one more bucket. We have buckets in here. Nope, but I have some iron. So, fluid collector right there. And I don't think this block needs water. Or it needs power. It doesn't look like it, so that's good. Take another quick nap. There we are. So, let's go see how this works. Excellent. So let's just see. If I put a fluid collector in the bottom here. Now what do we got? Zero of 800 millibuckets. Let's just see. I just dropped. Come on, come on. Maybe it's got to be above the water. Just take a look at the block first. That's probably what I did. So, if I put it... still wrong. There, that's a little better. Yeah, that could be a problem if I take it from the wrong spot, though. Hold on, let me just see here. Transfer node fluid. That's filling up. There, that is working. So all we need to do now is not mess all this up. Why don't we move this guy? Really? You're going to do that to me right now, aren't you? Cool. We could put this right here. Put you in there, and then I just need one more bucket. Perfect. So I got some more iron. I'll set this maybe just right here for right now. You can decide what to do with it later, but I need a bucket. From here and place it here. There we are. Now we'll just bring this guy straight across. There. Now hopefully everything gets filled with water. There it is. It's working. So on the top here, we want to put one of these guys there with sand. Oh. And hopefully when this is transformed, we'll be able to pull it out, probably with transfer node items. And we're also going to need the transfer node coming out the side of here. And let me just connect these. And then like this. Pretty simple. Throw that on there. It's working. But now we're out of sand, but that's cool. So this is how we're going to get our soul sand. It's going to keep filling up. Maybe I'll put a fluid, some storage fluid thing here, so it'll fill up a little quicker, hopefully. But guys, we've actually just automated soul sand. I'm going to have to get some sand and a whole bunch of sand into here, but that's not going to take long. But I'm going to do that quickly. We're going to sift up some soul sand. We'll be able to get back to work. And welcome back. We're all ready here. We got our drawer controller. And I was thinking, why don't we put it right here? So now, in theory, anything that can go into the system will go in the system, as long as, clear from the back here, item laser relay. Can we reach? That's the next question. I want to right click with this guy. And right click with this guy. Perfect. Now I think this is when I need the compass. There we are. So them guys falling. Let me just see here. So, are these filling up at all? Nothing. Let me check one more thing. Oh, I got it working. Sorry, guys. So, if you look here, everything's slowly draining out, which is kind of cool. Then I could switch all three of these or add three laser relays. Let's see. Only thing I worry about now. Yeah, you can see it filling up. I'm afraid these guys are going to fill up. I think I've extended all of these to a larger stack size, so it might last. But I don't know. I don't know. But as of right now, guys, we have wireless. And the way it worked, I forgot to put my item laser relay back on here after I set up the item interface, and I put, just a pipe going in there. Pretty easy, so that's good. We need to, I think what we should do is, where are they? Let's throw two more in here. That's great for water. We don't want water. Energy. Oh, did it go back? Did I miss it? Water. And then from water, let's just see. It looks full. There, that time it worked. Not sure what I did the first time. But I'm wondering, can I just click you? Click you. This will unload everyone into this chest. And hopefully from this chest, bring it all up there. That's what it looks like it's doing. But that is pretty sweet, eh? We have the double crusher. We should build ourselves the powered furnace as well, right? Why not, eh? Let me get the stuff ready. There we are. Pretty easy. Couple quick steps. And now we have a powered furnace as well. And these work exactly the same. You know, you hit the auto split, it'll split it into two. Pretty good. So we do now have our basic smelting system. I gotta run some pipe to it, get all that stuff set up. I'll probably move this upstairs so close to the storage system so we could pull things out. But yeah, guys, that's a pretty good start on actually additions. We got a couple cool things. I mean, there's so much more. We should look into getting a drill as well. What do we got? It's actually not too bad. And it drills like an all-around, does everything. Digs, does, yeah. What does this do? Oh, you can change the color of it. That's pretty cool. They also level up and can get epic. All this crazy. Oh, I did totally forget about the second tier. So another way to craft things, like this is the one way. The other way is using four display stands and one in power. Oh, that's not too bad to build, but we can do that another time, I think. We are out of time for the day. We got quite a bit into actually additions, which is awesome. We have some big things left to do, but we are starting to automate our storage system, which is awesome. I might be able to put these relays right onto the sieves to bring it up, but next episode we are going back to Britannia. We're gonna go back over there, get some more accomplished. I thought I had food. I'm out. But yeah, guys, not today. We are out of time. But thanks for watching. If you liked it, don't forget to hit that like button. Check out the other guys on the server. They are all doing awesome things as well. And we'll see you in the next one, buddies. Later.